Didn't hear you. Excuse me. Typical, I'm always a little bit late. You know how I operate. All right, folks. Where's my timer?
I have it up here, and whenever you start talking, I'll set the timer, okay. And you'll hear the bell whenever 3 minutes is up.
All right, guys.
Welcome.
Well, my name's Primetime 99 Alex Stein, and I'm sick and tired of this police force, the Dallas Police Department.
Man, I got to say something real quick before I get this video started. I agree with what he says here, seriously, okay? And what he's going to talk about this here, this piece of video is something else, man. And Alex Stein, he does what he does best, okay? But this time, it's saying a troll, okay? This is not a troll like he does when he comes to city council. And he comes up here and he trolls the council. He's good. Very, very good. He's a professional troll. I like Alex a lot. But this time he's real serious. And he should be serious. If you guys didn't know, and I didn't know this, I just saw this, what he just brought up, talking about a police officer, a sergeant, who's got some time in on the Dallas police force. When he posted an X post, okay, in regards to the assassination attempt on Donald Trump. Guys, you got to hear this. If you haven't heard it yet, you have got to hear this. And how he just flat out goes off. He goes off, and I applaud him on his passion about this, because when he said this and laid it out about this, I 100% agree. And honestly, I think I would take it even farther. But let me get this thing set up for you guys so you can see exactly what I'm talking about here with Alex Stein. And he's here with also an individual, John, from, was it Fish Tank Live or something? That's something I don't see or anything else like that. He's also here with Alex Stein, too, as well. And he's got some things to say on this. And you guys, just... yeah, just check this out here, man. This is, it's something else, I swear.
You have a guy, a 14-year veteran, a sergeant, by the name of Arturo Martinez, that thinks it's really cute and cool to say that the assassin that shot Donald Trump should aim better. And I think it's freaking disgusting that we have a police force, people that, look at these guys, look at these cowards. You guys think it's okay to say, oh, we should aim better? Isn't
Excuse
he one of your brothers?
Me. Excuse me.
I don't think it's
Excuse
okay.
Excuse me.
Address me.
Excuse you.
Address me.
Listen here,
please.
Grandma. I can come up
Do
here and say
yell.
What I need to say.
Do not yell.
Why are you yelling then?
Hey, excuse me, Mr. Stein. This is not appropriate. It's not under the conduct. Can you please speak with kind of some respect, and please only address me as
okay.
the chair.
Okay. I'll
Thank
have
you,
some
sir.
Respect, but I'm very frustrated because I don't think
okay.
it's very respectful.
Okay. Speak to me, please.
I don't
do not
think
speak
it's
to
respectful
officers.
For a Dallas police officer, 14-year sergeant, to say that an assassin should have aimed better when they tried to kill the 45th president of the United States, Donald Trump. I want a police force that doesn't put their politics first, that has a brain, unlike some of these people in this room. And that's what's so disgusting, is that we got a city out there, you have multiple people out there smoking fentanyl, smoking crack, as I walked in here, people smoking drugs out there at City Hall. You guys aren't gonna arrest them, but the Dallas Police Force, they got enough time to go out there and tweet, I think the assassin should have aimed better. Yeah, well, it's not funny to me. I don't think it's very funny at all, because I put my safety in these officers' hands. That's their job, is to protect us, to protect a president. And we're in Dallas, where JFK was assassinated. Mm-hmm. So there's a little more scrutiny that is upon us as a city, because we were the last city to have a president assassinated. But see, that's the problem. This city is all about race and gender. You probably don't like me because I'm coming out here and calling out a guy because he's Hispanic and probably likes illegal immigration. I don't know his politics, but I know that he wants the president to die, and I think that he should not be a part of the Dallas Police Force. And of course, the chief, Eddie Garcia, doesn't have the balls to come in here and face us man to man, and that's what's so pathetic. You guys call this a police oversight commission? I see a couple police, I see a bunch of people that are not qualified to stop what's actually happening in this city. You know, I don't like having my car broken into, all right? And you guys tax us out, you know, the money that I pay in taxes in this city is ridiculous. And what does it go to? So Mayor Johnson can go cheat on his wife. So Chief Garcia can get another tattoo.
Squeeze about police. talk to us, please.
Yeah, well, I'm saying the police are under the mayor's jurisdiction. So I'm sick and tired of living in a place where I got to live in fear that there might be a police force that might want our president dead. So if our police force won't protect the president, why would they protect me? Why should I have any hope or faith in our law enforcement if they think it's so cool to go on social media and type aim better? That's disgusting. We almost had the world change in an instant.
Hey, thank you, Mr. Stein. Your time is up. I appreciate you being here.
Okay, well, I mean, it's funny that this woman just, you know, interrupted me the whole time.
Hey, your time is up. Thank you so much.
You guys need to do better. You heard me.
Now, let me stop it right there. Before the next individual comes up, Alex is right. He is right. 100% right. And, What he had to say, let me break another view here. What he had to say, man, seriously, it pisses me off, seriously. And I'm not pissed at Alex. I'm pissed at the fact of a 14-year sergeant on police force. You seriously put your politics ahead of your job or your oath to protect and serve. As I said, I back the blue, but I'm not one who backs a blue no matter who, okay? I call out the ones who need to be called out. The sergeant needs to be called out because as the way I see it, you have the right to say what you want to say, and that's fine. It's freedom of expression, freedom of speech. I believe it. I am a constitutionalist, okay? So I do believe in that. But there's consequences to the way you think. There's consequences to what you say and how you put it out there. And you put that crap out there like that, on social media, post that tells me something about you, seriously, that you would have the balls to actually sit there and text anything or post anything on social media as a fact that we should have aimed better. We're talking about somebody who almost assassinated a former president, and Alex is right. It would have changed this world in an instant, man, over this, which I still, honestly, from more and more details of things that's just real shady, man, just coming out more and more and more here lately since that event. To me, it starts smelling like setup, man. And I start smelling setup personally like about the next day, even that day, actually. And the more I kept thinking about it the next day, I'm thinking, well, okay, something's not right, because how do you let somebody crawl up on basically damn near a flat roof? That roof was, what, a 1 to 12 pitch, maybe 2 to 12? I mean, it's damn near flat. How do you let somebody crawl up on a roof 130 to 150 yards away at a direct line sight at the stage, former president? And then why was he still up there? When this dude was suspicious anywhere from what, damn near an hour up before, even longer than that, he was a suspicious character they were looking for. Why was the president still allowed to go up there? Anyway, that's another rant. But like I said, what Alex said is right. And honestly, the way I feel about it, the man should have his badge pulled. Okay, I'm not for people losing their job or anything like that over certain things, but certain things do have a consequence, because to me, that tells me, like I said, it tells me something about your mindset, that you honestly have the balls to say something, because if you feel that way, you all in your feelings about the fact that you, that Trump deranged, that you don't like Donald Trump, and that he almost was assassinated in front of his family. What does that say, man? What does that say about you as an individual? I wouldn't trust you being on the police force as a sergeant, man. Wearing a badge and out here in a job trying to protect me. And that's where your mind is. You got to be twisted, man. There's something misaligned with you. This dude needs to be reevaluated instantly. I mean, like right now, reevaluated. Pull him out of service, reevaluated. And on top of that, I'm serious. The man should lose his badge. He should lose his badge. And I'm not going to change my mind on that. Because you have to be effed up to have a mindset to think that just because you pissed off because you don't like a certain candidate. I can't stand Joe Biden. I've never liked that dude. To me, he's been a lying dirtbag, racist piece of crap as long as I know, and he's been around for years. And when he got plucked out of the land of obscurity by Obama, there was a reason why, because Obama knew he could basically control this moron. But Joe Biden has been a jack off his entire life. in my opinion. I can't stand him. But I don't wish any harm on the man, okay? I don't wish to see the man assassinated. I don't wish any harm upon his family at all. Even though his family's, I mean, my personal opinion, his family is full of dirtbags. His family's jacked, absolutely jacked up, man. And as corrupt as he is, I still don't wish to see any bad harm such as that to him, to his family or anything else like that. Because my mind is not twisted, man. It's not. So I don't know. I don't know what else to say about this, though. But let's bring up this next one here, individual here. And let's hear what he has to say.
Alex, okay. That looked awesome. We actually just kept your feed because it was better.
Mr. Stein, have you filed a complaint?
I filed a complaint with the Northwest Police Division, and I posted the video online. I can send you a copy of that video of me filing the complaint.
But have you filed a written complaint with the Office of Police Account Oversight?
I actually did send them an email, okay. But I actually filed a police report with the Northwest Division that's right at Northwest Highway next to Bachman Lake.
I don't know that'll properly get it to our jurisdiction. If you want to fill out and sign a complaint online,
yes,
that'll
okay, I'll get that done ASAP.
Thank you.
Next, we have Dinell Lane. Dinell Lane, we'd love to invite you forward if you have any comments. Okay, you declined this time. Thank you for being here, Mr. Lane. We appreciate it. And the last in person that we have is John Tent King. Oh, John Tent King.
The trolling is getting ready to start here. But real quick, before I start, just real fast, pay attention to big boy over here on the left, over here sitting on the council down here on this board or whatever, between him. Alex went off on that lady, I mean, as far as, and she just got upset and just pissed off. And it's like, when you come out and start yelling at him, it's like the man's upset and he's going to start yelling. Hell, I'd start yelling, you know. It got a little heated, but like I said, no disrespect or anything else like that, but I'm glad he didn't back down from it, you know, seriously.
Thank you for being here, Mr. King. And whenever you begin, we'll begin your 3 minutes. And when you hear the bell, please respect the three-minute timeline. Thank you so much.
First off, my pronouns are King and Emperor, so don't get that confused, okay? You know, it's kind of sad to watch you guys almost become like the city called Portland. You guys are all becoming meth heads, crack heads, all the way around out in Dallas. You know, Dallas used to have a name for itself. Now you guys are kind of becoming just like a knockoff of Portland, you know. Oh, by the way, I'm running for city council in Bend, Oregon, so make sure you guys vote for me if you're watching this in Bend, Oregon. But you guys really should stop what you guys are doing. Like, Mayor Johnson, you know, he's a adultery. If you go back to the Bible, I'm sure Jesus Christ wouldn't be approving of his actions.
Mr. King, please don't talk about anyone disrespectfully.
No.
Speak,
I wasn't talking about
me.
I was just stating some facts. I think
you
misunderstood, you know. It's just facts. Jesus would have not approved of that at all. You know, he didn't approve of adultery. You know, it's not a thing you should be doing in the Bible. I don't know if you guys even listened to the young lady that was down here a little bit ago. You guys, these police officers would be boning the elderly lady here instead of stopping the crackheads outside and the meth heads and helping the homeless people. Your police officers would enjoy to bone older ladies on their arms. She has videos of your police officers of all the abuse they have done to her. Is that what you guys like doing, abusing elderly ladies? Is that what you guys get off on, abusing old ladies? No? Anyone? No, okay, I didn't think so. But maybe you guys should stop abusing elderly ladies, you know. Oh my goodness. Oh. Mixel, every one of you guys, if you guys are watching this, go watch Fish Tank Live Season 3. Go watch Ice Poseidon's Hunger Games stream, guys. It's going to be placed in Austin, Texas, where people are going to be getting used with tear gas. A lot of people are going to be exposed to tear gas in this Texas country. But, you know, this is just a good time to kind of make fun of you guys. It's kind of funny, to be quite honest. Like, watching you guys' city become a new fucking Portland. Like, what the fuck is wrong?
Foul language is not allowed.
What?
No.
What?
foul language is not.
I was a piece of pediment. You misunderstood me. Sorry. don't discriminate against me again, please. It's not respectful at all. What?
Troll.
What do you want to say? What? No, you didn't say anything? I'm finishing my few minutes.
Address me only, please.
What?
The rules are you can only speak to me as the chair. That's.
Wait, why did he speak to me? Am I not supposed to respond when you guys interrupt me?
Can
he speak
comments?
To me first? Tell him not to speak to me if you don't want me to talk to him again, okay?
I can only ask you.
Get your people back in line. Get your people in line and then I would line up after you, okay?
All right, thank you, Mr. King. Appreciate that.
Yeah, I would appreciate your people lining up. Anyways, please force to really stop, bony elderly ladies. I just want to say that.
Thank you, Mr. King.
And pro over here, guys. John Tent, baby.
John Tent.
Thank you very much for that comment.
Trolling. Straight trolling. Which, honestly, they deserve to be trolled. Because, like I said, what Alex said about that man, seriously, that would have me heated. I'm serious. That would have me so heated. And even when I saw this and saw the post would put it up, I'm like, dude, I honestly start getting pissed off. I'm just like, are you kidding me? 14-year veteran here on a police force, and you seriously put your politics out there like that? Yeah, questions. I said it before. It makes me question you, man. It makes me question your mind state. Where the hell is your mind at to where you would put your politics out there like that up front? Because you don't like somebody. You that deranged over an individual you don't like. Sick, man. Like I said, you need to be reevaluated and have your badge pulled for real. Done. Because I wouldn't trust anybody seriously that I know has a mindset like that. Don't mean where you're that far gone to say you should aim better. See, what's wrong with you? The hell is wrong with you? To even think some crap like that, man. And then not only think it, have the balls to sit down and put it out there for the whole world to see. You kidding? It's out there on the internet. It's out there forever. The hell is wrong with people, man? I swear to God, the Trump derangement, man, is just unreal. It is unreal. I've never in my life seen so many people deranged over this man. I don't understand the derangement that comes out of people over him. I mean, it's just, they think he's like, the left honestly thinks this dude is a devil, but it's kind of ironic because a lot of crap that comes from the left is straight up evil. I don't know, man. I don't know. Like I said, there's a lot of things. There's a lot of things that I could go off on about as far as the progression of people falling away from the church, falling away from faith, and a big part of that was with COVID. All right. Let's be honest. The first things they closed was churches. Call them super spreaders. That's the first thing they closed down. The one thing that people needed to have just some mental solace and to hold on to something, to have faith in something else over a virus that we had no information about at all. And the media hyped up like it was like people were dropping like flies. Come 30 days later, yeah, it didn't seem so much. 60 days, 90 days. After about 90 days, yeah, we pretty much figured to say, okay, listen, man, this is a glorified flu virus. And after about 3 months, going into 4 months, we can see exactly who it's attacking here and who's more vulnerable to it, okay? So, and I had it twice, okay? The first time it sucked. Second time wasn't even half as bad. Anyway, that's the video, guys. Like I said, man, this is, I swear, we are living in a crazy time, and it is so much crazy news is coming up. It's very hard for me, even me, to keep up with a lot of this stuff, too. I see this, and there's a lot of things I got to say, because there's a lot of things I say during the day, and Lord knows I would love to be here full-time doing this, and I'm working my tail off to do it full-time, trust me, but I still have I have a daytime job I got to handle, so... But until I get to that point, man, I'm just going to keep plugging away at this. Let me know in the comments below, guys, if you want me to get a chance to start doing some live stuff. I honestly think I can do live stuff a little bit better than the recorded stuff that I'm doing right now, because there's extra steps into the recording process that is recorded, then go back and edit it and everything, and all of that takes time. I'd rather just be on more of myself, like you see now, live, boom, put it up, there you go. It's clean, it's pure cut, there's no edits, there you go, that's what it is, man. And just keep on pushing from there. I honestly do want to do some live stuff, and I think I'm going to start here real soon. But anyway, let me know what you think in the comments below about this. What do you think about police officers, or seriously, or anybody in that, how can I say, in the field of protecting or being in a position to where you would assume you would put some trust into them to have your protection? I don't totally trust police officers at all. I don't trust the government either when it comes to it. I only trust myself to protect me, okay? That's why I also train and teach, you know, tactical weapons as well, as you guys know on my other channel. But yeah, man, I don't like a mindset like that with somebody that has an authority position such as that or even higher. That's sick. It's very, very sick. We got to do better, people. We have got to do better. Anyway. Guys, let me know. Don't forget everything to, you know, the whole deal. Like, subscribe, comment, share, the whole deal. And just keep praying, everybody. Keep praying. Keep your head up, man, and keep praying for the best here. And make sure you get out and vote early. Vote early. Vote early. Conservatives, vote early. Do not wait till game day. No more of that. No more. As much as we love to, I'm saying it. Everybody else is saying it. I've been saying it. Not this time around. When early voting starts anywhere in your state, whenever it starts, get out early and vote. Vote early. Bank it early. That way it gives the left less chance to pull bull crap at the last minute. Okay? So go bank that vote early. All right? And I'll see you on the next one.